Now, my brother knew he wasn't allowed to drive Dad's car, but that didn't stop him grabbing the keys as soon as Mum and Dad left the house and taking the old Chrysler Valiant out on a gravel road. I'm not sure just what was going through his mind when he crashed the car, but I know something went through the radiator, and of course, he didn't tell Dad. I can still remember my father putting water into the radiator and being perplexed that the radiator wouldn't fill up. Well, of course, then he realized water was coming out the bottom of the radiator as fast as he was putting it in the top. Now, in the same way, when we leave God out of our lives, it's like we're trying to put water into a broken radiator or into a bucket with a hole in the bottom. Notice what God says in Jeremiah 2:13. For my people have committed two evils. They have forsaken me, the fountain of living waters, and hewed them out cisterns, broken cisterns, that can hold no water. It's a graphic representation of what happens when we turn our back on God. It's like trying to fill a bucket with a hole in it. Turning away from God is to reject the fountain of living water and replacing it, that is replacing God, with a tank or a container that's broken or filled with holes. This is the futility of going it alone without God. We might think we're worldly wise, we might think we're enlightened or free thinking, but the bottom line is, we're just trying to put water into a radiator that has a hole in the bottom. I encourage you today, take God with you. Include God in your plans. Look to God for guidance. He'll respect your wishes if you want to live your own way, but He knows that it's just better for you when you let Him guide and bless your life. Without God, a broken cistern. Your life just can't hold water. But with God, everything's going to work out okay, and you'll be blessed. I'm John Bradshaw for It Is Written. Let's live today by every word.